Look how smooth it is.
Yes.
Yeah, we're on that 21st century wild grail. You'll know when we get on the oven. Yes, you will. All right. So, Santa Fe. I won that three railroads. How many serve Santa Fe today? How many railroads? One? Well, you know you're on one for sure. That's a savings. Did you notice another train at the station? Yeah, the railroad. So Pan Am RX, Mexico Railway, Rio Metro Transit, that, and Sky Railway are serving the same way. Two railroads built this railroad. So, I'm going to go back up to Acoma. I'll be back to see you guys in a little bit. Got Dash Bar. Molly Corson Strong. She's good. Take good care of the people that take good care of you, I always say. And we've got the ops manager for the railroad on board, Brian. Raise your hand. Big round of applause. Sky Railway support is what makes this possible today for you folks. So they're a good and valued partner, and we're really happy to have the opportunity to have you experience this. How many of you have been on the train before on Sky Railway? Well, I hope after today, you'll leave without coming back out. Let me give you a personal tip.
Before.
over there, why do we have Sandia and the Manzanos? Because there's a crack in New Mexico. You know that? There's a big crack in New Mexico. The Rio Grande Rift. It's where our plate, it's where our tectonic plate was breaking. It's stabilized now. There's nothing that says it won't reactivate. But that rift is what the river follows. And when that rift opened on either side, adjustments to the landscape caused, to get my shirt to work, it really could be a good demonstration. When it tilted up, that block that formed the Sandia, on the west side is steep, on the back side is shallower, and in the area over there around Cedar Crest, you know, who goes to Burger Boy? Burger Boy on 14? That's a good place. If you look at an aerial photo of that area, you'll see, like my shirt, it has all these accordion-like ripples because that's called a fault block. It tilted up. Manzanos, same thing. Sacramento Mountains, down further, same thing. Big chunks of earth it tilted up. You can say, how deep's that crack? 6 miles. And then deeper below that, but 6 miles. But wait a minute. Now, if you're up on Sandia, it looks like a long way down to Albuquerque, but not 6 miles. That is filled in with gravel. That's why Albuquerque doesn't have the water problems that other places have. That's a huge aquifer. And it fills up. There's water coming down the Rio Grande section. A lot of interesting geology, a lot of interesting geography, and a lot of interesting history here. All right, any questions before I go back up? Make sure nobody's jumped off the train on Acoma. Yes, sir.
When you said that the Indians left because of the climate,
it was the West went into a mega drought. We went into several mega droughts. One of the worst ones was around the year 1100, followed then by another one that came in the 1200s into 1300. And it just made it very difficult in a land that was already marginal to continue. The other thing was the Athabascans. That's the Navajo or Diné people and Apache. They came down from the north. And the Plains Indians, who were getting squeezed environmentally, were moving in from the east. And they began attacking the settlements that were on the eastern side of the Puebloan territory. And those attacks finally ran a number of people.
this path. I don't know how to get to it. It's the same one. I think this is the one. They said the rail trail goes all the way to Eldorado. I think so. This is not paved, but the one in Santa Fe is paved, but once it gets down to past Rabbit Road, it... I like that one. I felt so at peace back there. No, when I went to the museum once, I walked way back on one of the trails and went to the Arroyo.